Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am founder and owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I specialize in serving nonprofits nationwide by helping them to increase profitability one mission at a time. In this session, we are going to specifically focus on how to customize reports using the settings and filters, how to group reports, how to memorize them, how to print, email, or export reports out of QuickBooks Online. So this is my QuickBooks Online sample company file. To get started in customizing a report, located on the left side navigation bar, so I'm going to click on Reports. When you click on Reports, it's going to bring you to this report center. You have three main tabs at the top. You have Standard tab. This is where all of the reports that you're going to need inside of QuickBooks Online is stored. And you have your custom reports. When we get to that part of the training, any report that you create, customize, and save will show up in this section. And you have management report. This is like fancy reports that if you want to customize group reports to send to your board members, you can use the management report to duplicate one of these samples and customize it to whatever you need. One of the key things that I do recommend as a nonprofit organization is you need to use one of the existing reports, customize it to whatever you want, and then save it. You can't really create your own reports out of the blue in QuickBooks Online. You have to use one of the existing ones that QuickBooks has provided for you. Now, you can favorite any of these reports. You can put a star right next to them and it just automatically show up at the top. That way you don't have to keep scrolling all the way to the bottom. So for the purpose of this demo, we are actually going to use the profit and loss report. When you open up the report, it will usually default to a date range that either says this year to date, but you can change it to whatever you want. So I am going to pick the date range of last year. And when I pick the date range of last year, it will automatically change these two dates for me, to change the start date as well as the end date for me. If you don't want to use any of the pre-custom fields for QuickBooks Online, you can just do the custom, select the custom option, and then manually type in the dates that you want. The display columns by this, you can display your columns instead of just showing me the total column only. You could display by months, you could display it by customers, you could display by years, you could display it by products and services, you could display it by however you want to see the information. Now, depending on the report that you run, you might have this column and more options, or you might not have it. Now, this option, you can select, do you want to show your roles by active roles inside of QuickBooks Online, or do you want to show active columns? If you want to do a comparison between the current year and the prior fiscal year, just to kind of see how has your net income changed from 2019 to 2018 or 2018 to 2017, you can select those options. So you could do previous period, previous year, year to date, percentage of either income or expense. So you could change and pick whichever options that you want to do to compare to another period inside of QuickBooks Online. Now, accounting method. Now, this is what I typically recommend for my nonprofits. So some of the nonprofits that I've dealt with, usually when they file their Form 990, or if they're a church, they usually are on a cash-based accounting method. I typically recommend running your reports on an accrual base. Yes, I understand you're filing your Form 990 on a cash base, but if you really want to see a good history and track the health of your nonprofit, you really want to run your reports on accrual base. QuickBooks makes it easier for you to switch from a cash to accrual base for any of the reports that you're running. Once you go through all of the settings at the top, you can just click Run Report. Now, since I selected Display My Columns by Months, it shows me everything by month. So I'm just going to switch this back to say totally and just click Run Report again. Now, while we are here, we're going to do a couple of things. So you can customize this report. You can change the name. You can change the title to whatever you want it to say. The date range will automatically show based on what you chose at the top. You can click on this customize button here. Here you have the general settings. So here you can, again, similar to what we covered in the prior place, you can change the report period. You can change the accounting method. For your number format, you can say, oh, I want it to show everything except zero amounts, or I want it to show without cents. I want my negative number to be in parentheses, and I want to show in red because that's usually a sign that I need to do something. That's usually the number formats and the negative number section. So under the rows, you can change it and say, okay, I don't want my columns by total only. I want it maybe by year or by quarter. You can change all of those options here. You can also filter your report. So you can filter if you don't want to see all of the expenses. Let's say you are a church and you actually want to customize a P&L by committee members, which is going to be your customer list, or if you want to customize your P&L for a specific grant, if you're just a regular 501c3 that deals with a lot of grants, if you want to customize your report to see only one grant, or if you want to customize your report to see only a group of income and a group of expenses. So you can click on the distribution account and just go through and manually select the accounts that you want to show up in the report. You only want to see fixed assets. If you don't want to see all income and expenses, you can kind of go through and check the box next to the accounts that you want to see. I'm just going to turn that off. If you want to customize your report, let's say you just want to see P&L from, you know, a vendor or like a customer only, you can select that option here. Same thing, if you want to do it for a vendor, you can select the option there. But if you are using a third-party payroll system, you're not going to see anything by the employee. If you are using QuickBooks Online built-in payroll system, then yes, this custom reports by employee will most likely show up for you. If you are a nonprofit and you're tracking using the class tracking feature, select the class option and then say, hey, I only wanted to pick certain classes and only show me a P&L by class. If you want to see like products and services, then this really impacts your income account. Okay, I want to see how much I spent on design, products and services, P&L for that. You can do that as well. So that's the filter option. You can also here under the header and footers, you can, like I mentioned, you can change the name. You can change the report title. Uncheck the box and say, I don't want the report period to show on the report. You can remove the date prepared and the time prepared. I usually leave the report basis checked. That way people can know this is an accrual report and this is not cash based. And you can kind of select, you know, do you want the header to be on the left side, right side? Do you want the footer to be on the center? You can do all of that. So once you go through all of your customization here, you can just click Run Report. And when you run the report, it's going to look like this. So we did the negative number with the red is showing up there. Another cool thing that you can do once you have finished with that customize button, what you can do is if you don't want all of the sub accounts to be visible, what you can do is click the collapse button. What this does is it collapses all the transactions into the parent accounts. That way everything is hidden and it's kind of clean. You can also sort if you leave it by default, it will sort according to how your trust of accounts was created inside of QuickBooks. If you are using account numbers, it's going to automatically sort it based on those account numbers. You can add notes at the bottom. So this is usually where I would add notes. Like, so if you have like a specific chart of account line here, that's maybe something you spent almost $1,000 and really you should not spend $1,000 more on legal and professional fees. For whatever reason, you can explain those line items accounts in the notes section. You've gone through all the process of creating your reports, customizing it. One thing that I do recommend is to save the report. So when you click on the Save Customization button, QuickBooks Online will automatically take the custom report name, which is exactly the name that you're seeing here. and it will ask you, do you want to add this report to a group? Group reports are very similar to that management report section that I mentioned earlier. So group reports like usually comes in handy if you want to, you know, do your P&L, your balance sheet, and your statement of cash flow. You want to do it in a group. That way, all those three reports will print in one massive PDF for you. You can use group reports. If you are also trying to email reports in a batch to board members or to your staff, whether you have an accounting department or you have an accounts receivable department, accounts payable department, or if you have different committees for your church, you can use the grouping to kind of group those reports and email those out of the system. So here you can add a group. Now share with, usually I recommend if you are creating reports that you run frequently and other people need to have access to the report, create custom reports for them and then share it with the entire users inside of QuickBooks Online. So when your treasurer or your board member logs in with their reports only access, they will be able to see those shared reports and don't have to recreate the wheel, especially if they have never used QuickBooks Online. This is a great way to make things easier for them to go in and, you know, get their own reports themselves. In this demo file, I'm not going to be able to share with all. I'm just going to do none. Just click save and it's automatically saved. Before we go back to the save reports piece, another cool thing that you can do out of here is you can email the report. You can actually print out the report. If you click on print, you can customize your print window. And all of this, I'm using Chrome browser, so a lot of this printing is customized to your browser set. You can here, when you go to print, you can say print here, or you can save it as a PDF, or you can email it. So if you click email, it will ask you, okay, enter the email address of the person you're trying to email the report to. So you enter that email address there. I always recommend CCing yourself in the reports. That way you make sure that the system actually sent it out. And you also have a copy in case that person comes back and say, hey, I never got the report you sent to me. You have a copy in your own inbox as well. And you can customize the subject, give your report a title, and all of that stuff. So I'm not going to send this. That's how you can send individual reports inside of QuickBooks Online. The gear icon, just you can do compact if you want to make all the content kind of squish in more. You could do that. So once you've gone through all of the steps of customizing your report, and you've clicked save, every time you edit this report or make changes to it, you want to always make sure you click Save Customization and just click Save. When you click Save Customization and go back to our report list, again, reports on the left side navigation bar, you want to go to Custom Reports. So the report that we just created and the group that we just created is all under here. Let's say you don't want to email that individual report and you want to email everything as a group. You can export this as PDF by clicking on the drop down next to the action button. You can delete this. You can also schedule it to go out on its own every month, every quarter, every year. So if you click on the edit icon, you can turn on set email schedule. So you can tell QuickBooks, hey, I want you to email this report on a monthly basis. They're like, I want you to email it to my board on the 10th of every month. You can also at the bottom say, I want to attach the report as an Excel file. Enter the email address. You can, again, CC yourself in the email and send it out of the system. When you go through all the setups, you can just click save and close. And the system will now show every month this report goes out. The end user does not need any QuickBooks login or anything like that. So every month, QuickBooks Online will automatically email the reports to the user that you have specified in that email field. So that, in a nutshell, is how you create a report, how you customize a report, how you do grouping reports inside of QuickBooks Online.